and welcome to the Daily Sporran again. And today I'm going to do a song called Singing All Day from the 1972 Living in the Past Jethro Tull album. Although it was recorded in September 1969 in Morgan Studios in London as part of the recording sessions that produced Sweet Dream. I think 17 as well was recorded in those sessions. 17 and this song, Singing All Day, both feel like songs that were improvised in the studio, probably as thought of as disposable B-sides. 17 ended up making the cut. Although interestingly, 17 is not included on Living in the Past. This song is just a kind of E minor jazzy riff, which doesn't go anywhere melodically or in terms of chord progression, but it's got three little twists in it that I want to point out at the end, which I think make it very Jethro Tully for a very simple song. Hope you enjoy it anyway. Wish me luck. Singing all day, singing about nothing, singing all day, singing about nothing, singing all day, singing about nothing, my, my, my. Ooh, my, my, my. Went down to the station to look for her there, looked through the crowds for a glimpse of her hair. Nothing to see, but the crowds keep a staring at me, my, my. Oh, my, my, my. Down in the street, trying to remember, shuffling my feet. Outside of menswear, is the hair in the fur coat? No, it's not December yet, my, my, my. Oh, my, my. Thank you. A very simple song. Three things. One is the lyrics have a really interesting twist to them. You hear it singing all day, singing about nothing. You think it's just someone bored and passing their time, but actually it's a song about desperation, which by the end feels actually quite pathetic, really. Desperation to see the woman that you fancy, that you love. And he's almost losing his cool and psychologically quite anxious. So I find there's a slightly sinister undercurrent to the lyrics of this song. It's not all sweetness and light. Secondly, you'll have noticed in this simple riff, but on the end of the second line, it just goes to a little E major chord with the first inversion. Just to throw it off kilter in a very Ian Anderson way. The third thing is, in the last verse, or the penultimate verse, I'll sing very softly, so if the phone rings, I can hear it, and then, I can hear it, the sound of the phone ringing, right? When everything goes soft, the phone just comes through. A D with a suspended second. I love that little twist. So three twists that make it more than a normal, straightforward, bluesy, B-side, riffy song. Hope you enjoyed it. See you soon.